Live look from our Weather Now camera here on this gorgeous fall day, looking live at Greencastle at DePaul University. Not a cloud in the sky, Todd.
No, near perfect conditions out there, Mark. The only flaw we have is just a little bit of a breeze, and that's not even that strong. There is not a cloud in the sky as you look from IMS back towards downtown Indianapolis. And you can see the camera shaking there just a little bit, but that's way up on the top of the pagoda. Once you get closer to the ground level, the wind is not nearly as strong. 56, the current reading at the airport in Indianapolis, 56 as well. In Muncie, 55 is the current temperature in Bloomington. So temperatures this afternoon are not going to vary much at all, no matter where you are, because we're all in the same air mass with the sunshine. And so we'll see our high top off right around 60 degrees. So we'll warm just a couple more degrees from where we are right now for that high temperature, but it's still above normal. The normal high is 55 this time of year. And then sunset this evening is at 5:33. And even this evening after the sun sets, because our winds are a little more southerly now, we are not going to see our temperatures fall off as quickly this evening as we did yesterday, and that's going to result in a warmer overnight period. I want to show you the whole country, and it is quiet really anywhere you go. The only rain that we have is moving through portions of southern Texas, and as you see, that's not a whole lot. So really all we have to focus on in the coming days is the temperature, because we are going to continue to have a very sunny pattern heading our way. So overnight tonight, we fall back down to about 45 degrees in Indianapolis, 43 in Bloomington as well as Columbus, and for tomorrow, Veterans Day, it's going to be a pretty nice day. Temperature will start off around 43 degrees and then warm up to a high of 55. But the high tomorrow is going to occur shortly after the noon hour. And then a cold front is going to come through. That front will not have any rain. Maybe you see a little more in the way of cloud cover tomorrow afternoon. But once that front goes through, look how quick the temperatures will start to fall off. By the time we get to 11 p.m., already down into the 30s. Now, the longest wait we ever had to get to a temperature of 32 degrees was November 8 in 1956. So we're already past that. So this has been a very warm and record-setting fall. Well, I think we finally get below that 32-degree mark come Saturday morning, because once the cold front comes through, the coldest air in nearly 8 months is set to arrive. Saturday morning, temperatures will be anywhere from 25 to 30 degrees. Sunday morning, just a smidge warmer, but still well below normal and still very cold as you head off to church or maybe out and about Sunday morning, 27 to 32 degrees. But the good news is each day, despite the cold start, we'll have lots of sunshine, warm to 50 degrees on Saturday, 56 on Sunday. And then by next week, Mark, temperatures are back up into the low 60s.